lights on, and it's lights out. We're going to be racing Dennis Ondjiu. Looked like he jumped the start there, didn't he? Eager to get away from that third place on the grid. It did look like Ondjiu on the 53 bike made a clear jump start. Sasaki gets away well from the head of that second row. He's immediately ahead of Diogo Moreira up into P3, but surely Ondjiu jumped the start. Confirmation on his screens as we thought we saw a double long lap penalty then for Dennis Ondjiu.
If I was Dennis Ondjiu, I'd be trying to serve this penalty as soon as he can. It's very, very difficult to get away here. So if he was trying to build up an early advantage, that's not really the kind of circuit where you can achieve that. So Ondjiu, through the first of his long lap penalty loops, he feeds in just behind his teammate, who ran into him a week ago, Jose Antonio Rueda. Ondjiu 17th with one long lap penalty still to serve.
Yeah, this was the very early error from Dennis Ondjiu. He knew immediately that he jumped the start. That was obvious. I mean, we could see it with the naked eye straight away. He was half a metre over his grid slot, wasn't he, before Moreira and Holgado from pole. Massi with a big slipstream finds himself on the inside of Sasaki. Massi goes from fourth to second in that first corner. Brilliant.
Sasaki fights back though.
Oh, that's brilliant by Sasaki. He's got through on Massi and through on Moreira. How on earth did he make that one stick? That was an awesome move. Attacking hard in this first sector. Now that Massi, can he retaliate? He certainly does. Oh, they run each other off the circuit almost. That was aggressive. That was aggressive in the extreme here as the title contenders touch here. This is Massi then into turn six. He got it all wrong. Got it all wrong, didn't he? And here comes Sasaki as well. The top two man in the World Championship. Top two here in Doha. And here comes Sasaki. Seven times in 2023. Ayuma Sasaki has led Moto3 Grand Prix on the last lap, and he hasn't won. He's not leading anymore. This is the exact same moment there. That Massi running in hot into turn six. And on the outside with nowhere to go. Sasaki, well, he's known as the crazy boy. He's going to be going crazy inside the helmet. There's just no way that Massi is making that corner, is there? Yeah, conduct warning then comes to Massi. So Sasaki, he picks up Massi there.
Here comes Massi once again at the inside of Sasaki. That was the cleanest move I think we've seen between Massi and Sasaki to this point. This is a good move, this, from you, Sasaki. There's ever so gentle contact on the inside, but based on what we've already seen from Massi so far in this race, I'm not so sure Massi could complain too hard at that one.
Massi is coming from a long way back again. How many overtakes has there been in this Qatar Grand Prix? He passes him as well on this lap 13, and that's really, really close. Called Massi on the dirty inside line there. Could have so easily washed out the front on that Leopard Honda. It's all on the line. High pressure, high stakes here in the Moto3 World Championship. On the brakes, Massi's a little bit out of shape. He's going to run in a little bit wide. Massi, though, does cut it back to a much later apex. And now Ricky Rossi's going to think about a move on the inside of Sasaki. Sasaki's getting properly beaten up here. Ayuma Sasaki loses three places in two corners.
He could lose the championship. Here comes Fernandez pushing Sasaki wide.
Oh, this is the dream scenario for Jaume Massi. He doesn't realise all the drama and chaos that's unfolding behind him for his chief championship adversary. Sasaki now gets picked up as well by Vicente Perez. The Moto3 World Championship slipping through the grasp of the Liqui Moly Husqvarna rider at the moment. The Husky man having a horror show late on here. Sasaki, full credit to him. He somehow finds a 205.501, fastest lap of the Grand Prix.
Sasaki is in touch now as he goes through on Holgado. Sasaki into fifth place. He still needs to overtake two more riders to keep this alive to Valencia.
Yeah, he knows. He's almost gone down, and that is game over. Sasaki was all in. He was going full send on the last lap. He has the massive moment. This is playing into the hands, isn't it, though, of Jaume Massi. And is Jaume Massi going to take Moto3 world title glory from the top step of the podium? He's been the top man in Moto3. Huge congratulations. Jaume Massi is your 2023 Moto3 world champion. And what a race he wins to take the championship. What an incredibly dramatic Qatar Grand Prix.
If you love MotoGP, like and subscribe. Like this, you don't miss a video.